can just come up and say hi. I don't visit you two
don't
lovebirds
visit,
enough.
I know. We're just up here chatting.
See you with that soul patch coming in.
Should I get
rid
of it?
No, I like it.
I'm going to cut it off tomorrow.
No, don't cut it off. Wear it for the show because you're going bald anyway. You need something on your face.
It goes like blonde hair.
That's good.
Then if you grow yours, I grow mine.
What did I tell you, man?
You don't ever
leave a poor guy alone. And the people picking on about his hair, leave him alone. Never. He doesn't want to shave his head. You don't want to shave his head.
Never a facial hair, dude.
Baby face.
I do. I'm getting close. I'm not there yet, but haircuts might be in my future.
You keep a line up, you'll be good, dude.
Angie line got rid of my rat tails before she left.
If you need help, just let me know. All right, Deanne. So, you know, obviously the big day is coming up here shortly.
Right. Nothing's changed,
here,
right?
What's the word on the street, Dan? Yeah. What have you been here? I'm getting, like, all kinds of different stuff, and I don't get it.
And, I mean, I just thought that it was the head of household's decision.
And we execute the plan.
Right, yeah, exactly. Right. And why, I mean, just there's just been some, I mean, mainly with me.
Is it paranoia? I mean, maybe it's a little paranoia.
Oh, I'm sure. Yeah. But I've been, you know, obviously I've been confronted by a couple people about the decision. And, you know, and I like Memphis. Don't get me wrong. Right. You know,
I think everyone likes Memphis. I don't think there's anyone that doesn't like Memphis.
No. You know, and so for me, it's, you know, obviously if I can have your, I mean, I have your word already.
Right. Yeah. I mean, that was the whole agreement with the whole seven, you know.
Right. It's just a little fearful that I'm scared that some people, you know, possibly might go a different way.
I mean, is it fearful just because of paranoia or is it like, you know what I mean?
Oh, yeah, I'm sure.
Because I'm sure, you know.
I'm sure a little bit, but it's just getting to be down to that day, and I was like, I just want to make sure, you know, I have Dan's word.
Yeah, no, I mean, as long as, I mean, you decide with the group, for the group, and that's what I told trigger.
Him. Right.
You know? But, I mean, I don't blame you, I've never been in your spot, but I'd be paranoid, too.
Yeah.
You know?
It's just a little scary, I'm like, oh my gosh, are people going to, you know, decide, because there's going to be some point that people are going to start breaking off.
Mm-hmm. You know, but I thought that was when, once we got to our final seven.
Which is it, right,
exactly.
Like, after this week.
And that's what I'm saying. I'm like, we're doing exactly what we're planning on doing. I put up two people out of those four.
Right.
You know, it doesn't matter which one goes home. As long as one of them goes home, I'm doing my job for a seven. I mean, I'm protecting a seven by sending one of the four home.
Exactly.
Angie was already out, whether it's Jesse or Memphis this week. We're doing exactly what we're planning on
doing.
Goal
accomplished.
But what I will let you know is, like I said, there has been a couple people that approached me.
In terms of changing the vote?
Mm-hmm. Well, not changing the vote.
Of other things. Of,
like
okay.
Changing, like,
you don't have to say
I,
it, but I know what you're talking
about.
I'm going
to go one way, and they're not happy with it whatsoever. Which I didn't ever question Keisha's decision. Right. Even later in the week, I said, hey, if you decide to change your vote, I'm with you 100%.
Right.
I don't care either way. You let me know. I have your back 100%.
So you're talking about being approached by the seven breaking off then sooner than we thought.
No. I was just approached by... Because obviously
I don't want to know names. You don't have to tell me. Don't.
Before going into this competition, I said my main target was Memphis.
Right.
I don't think it's fair that he has a $50,000 car. Mm-hmm. I don't like the way he approached me.
Right.
He's after Jerry.
No, you don't have to explain your reasons why to me. You know what I mean?
But I just, like I said, I've been kind of approached by a couple people that don't want Memphis to leave and are kind of strong-arming me to go one way, and I don't know, it's just difficult. I just want your word, like you said, that you'll vote with the way I
mean, that was original, when we brought in the seven, we said HOH.
What I'm asking you is that if some people decide to go elsewhere with their vote, which I'll catch them, because obviously it'll be apparent, I have your word to go with what I decide to do. Not what any of the other people decide to do, but what
I was the whole, I mean, that was the whole agreement with the seven, you know, why would it change now? You know,
why would
people get nervous now? You know, we still have, three more people to get out, then start to get nervous.
This is why.
Two.
This is why I think.
Two people to get out.
The only reason why I think they would do that is to basically they're looking out for themselves and they're looking at if we keep, say, Jesse around, then they would be a target the next week if Jesse were to win head of household. So if they're
and they're not a target of Memphis.
They're not a target of Memphis.
So
that's what it boils down to.
But yet I'm a target of Memphis, and Jerry is, and Jerry's the power veto winner, and I'm the head of household. But they don't give a shit about that.
Right.
They give a shit about themselves. and what's
it's like selfish in a way.
Well, the whole thing is, I mean, it boils down to numbers. No matter, everyone's got someone coming after them.
And that's exactly what I said. I go, then you guys went head of household.
Yeah, exactly.
That's what I told them. I said, you know what? If you're so fearful, you know, you hang up there for 3 hours like I did bring up Michelle, which Michelle could have easily put up any one of us seven, first of all. And don't tell me, I mean, I never once went to Keisha and said, this is who I want you to vote for. Never. Keisha decided that on her own, you know? And I never once went against her word. I said, if you want Jesse out, I'll vote Jesse out. If you want Angie out, I'll vote Angie out. Never once did I strong arm her, never came after her, never ganged up on her. Well, I'm more being ganged up on, which isn't fair to me.
No, and I understand it's your decision. Can I ask you what percentage of your final decision, are you 100 or are you 90 right now?
I mean, honestly, I want to keep this between us because I am going to pull everybody in the room.
Right.
But I'm voting Memphis out.
Right.
That's what I agree to. Mm-hmm. I'm not changing my decision because Jesse went after Libra and had a fight with her. That's not my problem. Mm-hmm. You know, if Libra and Jesse are arguing in another room, that's not my problem. You know, when Jesse attacked me last week, I could have went up to Keisha and said, I want Jesse out. You need to put Jesse out. Jesse attacked me.
Right. But the other thing is, too, and it's your prerogative, but I don't think you should get paranoid by them voicing concern. Now, if it's more than voicing concern, then, I mean, that's one thing. But, I mean,
I'm just hoping that the seven stays intact. Is what I'm really hoping. Because if someone, and like I said, I want to bring everybody in, you know, and I want their opinions. Right. I'm not saying that, you know, the decision isn't done now.
Right.
So I'll definitely listen to every single person in the group.
Right.
But going into this, like I said, I wanted Memphis out before I went head of household. Mm-hmm. It's not like I'm changing my vote all of a sudden. You know? And that's the thing is, when we went through the line and everybody said, who do you want out if you become head of household? Mm-hmm. I never once said I wanted Jesse, I said, I want Memphis out.
Right.
And it's no different than last week. We all respected Keisha's, you know, her wishes of wanting Angie out and everyone.
No, and the thing with, I don't know what the conversations were, but, I mean, obviously paranoia runs rampant in this house, but if someone's voicing concern, I would just take it as that, as a concern and not like a, you know, a mutiny, you know.
I'm hoping so. And that's why I'm having you up here. Maybe you can calm me down a
little
bit.
Yeah, no,
but,
I mean, but I can't speak from your spot. I haven't been in the spot where I'm making the call and I got to depend on.
Yeah.
Six other people to do it,
right.
You know?
Right.